Hi dear friends, welcome back to Curious With. I'm Dr. Mohsina. In today's video, we will see a bacterial disease, a clostridial infection in sheep known as black disease, also known as infectious necrotic hepatitis. So let's begin. Infectious necrotic hepatitis or black disease is a highly lethal acute toxemia of sheep, sometimes affecting cattle also, and rarely pigs and horses. Etiology and pathogenesis. The etiologic agent of infectious necrotic hepatitis is Clostridium novae type B, a soil-borne bacteria and is a part of intestinal microbiomes, also present in the liver of herbivores and may be present on skin surfaces and dormant in muscles, and is a potential source of wound infections. You can see the picture of Clostridium novae type B here. Fecal contamination of pasture by carrier animals is the most important source of infection. The organism multiplies in the area of liver necrosis caused by migration of liver flukes and produces a powerful necrotizing toxin called alpha toxin. The disease is worldwide wherever sheep and liver flukes are both found, and is increasing in cattle where liver flukes are accidentally introduced. You can see a picture of liver infected with a liver fluke here. Clostridium novae has been suspected but not yet confirmed as a cause of sudden death in cattle and pigs fed high concentration grain diets and in which pre-existing lesions of liver were not detectable. The lethal and necrotizing toxins damage hepatic parenchyma, thereby permitting the bacteria to multiply and produce a lethal amount of toxin. Here is another picture of liver infected with fasciola hepatica, that is liver fluke. Coming to the clinical findings, typically death is sudden without clear clinical signs. Affected animals often are 2 to 4 years old, tend to lag behind the flock, assume external recumbency and die within a few hours. Most cases occur in summer and early fall when liver fluke infection is at highest. The disease is most prevalent in well-nourished adult sheep and seem to be limited to animals infected with liver flukes. Differentiation from acute fasciolysis may be difficult, but per-acute death of animals with typical lesions found on a necropsy examination should arouse suspicion of infectious necrotic hepatitis. Now let's see the lesions. The most characteristic gross lesions are, as shown in this picture, grayish yellow necrotic foci in the liver tissue caused by migration of young flukes. Here you can see another picture of a sheep liver, ovine liver infected with black disease. You can see multiple well demarcated randomly distributed pale foci of necrosis in an ovine liver here. In another picture, in the picture on the left side, you can see a fasciola or liver fluke infected liver. Here black parasitic debris can be found in the liver. And in the right side picture, there is black disease, dark brown swollen liver showing necrotic areas of 1 to 2 cm diameter surrounded by a zone of hyperemia. Coming to histopathology, histologically liver lesions include central eosinophilic inflammation, that is fluke induced, surrounded by a coagulation necrosis with an outer rim of neutrophil. So in this picture you can see a large focus of coagulated necrosis in an equine liver with an inflammatory cell rim stained with HND. So here you can see large number of rod-shaped bacteria at the periphery of necrotic area, that you can see on the right side of this picture, with a contiguous leukocytic infiltrate of viable and degenerate neutrophil at left, stained with HND stain. The The lesion is positive for gram-positive rods on microbial culture. This is the culture plate and you can see gram-positive rods in here. Other common findings are enlarged pericardial sac filled with straw colored fluid as seen in this picture here. You can see straw colored fluid in the enlarged pericardial sac, and sometimes excess fluid can be seen in the peritoneal and thoracic cavities. Usually there is extensive rupture of capillaries in the subcutaneous tissue. So usually in the subcutaneous tissue shows extensive rupture of capillaries, which causes the adjacent skin to turn black. That's why this disease is infectious necrotic hepatitis is having another common name, black disease, because the skin is turning to black color. Coming to the diagnostic techniques, diagnosis of infectious necrotic hepatitis is based on history, clinical evaluation and lesions found at necropsy. As we already discussed, diagnostic confirmation is via PCR assay or IFAT or other laboratory testing, as in other any other type of clostridial infection. Coming to the control measures, the treatment of this disease is very difficult. It is it is unrewarding. So we have to go for control measures. Incidence of this disease may be lowered by reducing the number of limnia species snail, because it is the intermediate host of liver fluke, or by otherwise reducing the fluke infection of cattle. You can see the picture of limnia snail here. So this is the intermediate host of liver fluke and liver fluke in sheep life cycle. Sheep ingest cyst or juvenile fluke and cyst and migrate through the liver of the host. Adult fluke reside in bile duct and lay eggs. And the fluke's eggs are passed in feces and miracidium hatch and they find the snail as intermediate host. Then cercaria leave the snail when the temperature and moisture levels are suitable and encyst the metacercaria on the pasture. And this sheep ingest the cyst with the grass and they get infected. However, these procedures are not always practical to control the limnia and control the fluke infestation. And active immunization with Clostridium novae aluminium precipitated toxoid seems more effective and can also be performed during outbreaks. Long-term immunity is achieved via one vaccination, and after this only new introductions to the flock, lamb and sheep brought in from other areas need to be vaccinated. This is best done in early summer. Pasture contamination can be minimized by proper disposal of carcasses via burning. So before winding up, let's see the key points of black disease once again. Infectious necrotic hepatitis or black disease is an acute toxemia primarily of sheep caused by Clostridium novae type B. Death is sudden, often without clinical signs, and seem to be limited to animals infected with liver fluke. The most characteristic gross lesions are grayish yellow necrotic foci in hepatic tissue caused by young migrating flukes. Control is by disrupting the life cycle of liver fluke by reducing population of intermediate snail host and by active immunization with Clostridium novae toxoid. So that's all about infectious necrotic hepatitis or black disease. So this is an important disease. So please go through all the aspects of this disease, and this disease is not having an effective treatment, so control measures are very important. If the video is informative, please like it and share it with your friends, comment your suggestions. And if you are new to this channel and not subscribed yet, please subscribe and click the notification bell so that you get notified every time I upload a video. See you soon with another video. Thank you. Bye.